for those who are in favor of an independent inquiry, they want to have an inquiry that is impartial, fair, and the inquiry should look at the whole saga. Of course, police actions unavoidably will be part of what is to be investigated, but all those factors, circumstances that have led to the escalation of the crisis, in my view, should be looked at, because this is the most serious crisis of governance in Hong Kong ever since 1997, and not since 1967.
Right. Well, that brainstorm session where you talked about the independent inquiry, the need for one, was back in August. We're now here in November, and there still isn't an independent inquiry. Carrie Lam, in fact, has hardened her position. She says, it's quite simple, the situation we face now is anti-government violence. The most effective solution is to tackle the violence head-on. Appeasing the violent rioters is not a solution. So she is toughening her stand. So I ask you again, in for her to go?
I think if any government faces the kind of crisis, challenge that is now happening in Hong Kong, there is a need to consider how to reshuffle the government in order to open a new page in terms of post-crisis remedial work, reconciliation, reform. Of course, the timing itself is a tricky one, because it is not just for Carrie Lam herself to decide what to do, because Beijing obviously has a view. And the current crisis has already escalated to a level where Beijing feels it is obliged to intervene. And indeed, Beijing has been much more vocal over the last few months.